平安。
Brothers and sisters, peace and be unto you.
我还没有准备好就上来了。
I haven't completely prepared before I go upstairs.
我正沉浸在最后一首诗歌的美好之中呢。
I'm still involved in the last beautiful songs.
很期待再唱一首歌。
I want to sing one more song.
等我们结束的时候再多唱歌吧。
When we can sing another song, one more song after we finish.
今天天气真好。
It's a beautiful day today.
也很冷啊。
But it's really cold.
我今天一出门觉得哇，就是寒气扑面而来。
And when I get out of the door, I feel that the chilly wind comes on my face.
但是到了教会见到大家特别高兴。
But when I came to church, when I saw the brothers and sisters, I feel pretty happy.
大家好吗？
How are you today?
太好了，太好了。
Good.
今天在开始分享之前，我先问大家一个问题。
Before I preach today, I want to ask you a question.
就是这个问题。
The question on monitor.
就是有什么东西我们不能够看见，但却是真实存在的。
Okay. So the question is this, are there anything that is invisible but is really there?
大家说十个啊，一个太少了，太小了。
Ten of them.
十个，十样人事物。
Ten of them. Yeah. What?
明天。神
，tomorrow, God, air,
空气
，the air,
风
，wind,
声音
，sound,
what? Love,
爱，
六个，什么？爱也说过了
，love, yeah.
思维
You're thinking、
对，还有什么
Anything else?
温度哈，温度哈
Temperature and this feeling
大家头脑比我发散我八个了还差两个神也说过了
So
魔鬼，哎呀，算他一个。
Devil, yeah. I think.
圣灵。
And Holy Spirit, I think everybody is more thoughtful than me.
天使啊。
Angel.
好了，已经十一个了，我们可以毕业了。
There's 11 already. We can quit.
有很多东西我们看不见，但却是真实存在的。
But there's many things we can't see it, but it's really there.
我相信诸弟兄相信我是有良心的人。
I believe that brother Nigel believe I'm a conscious man.
但是大家看不到我的良心在哪里。
But you can see my where's my conscience.
虽然我看不到他的，我也相信他是有的。你看不到你的良心，那我相信你是有的。
Even though I can't see his, but it's really there as well.
许多的东西我们都看不到，但真实存在。
But there's many things we can't see it, but it's really there.
我们今天就来讨论学习一个人，他看不见，但却真实存在。
Today we're going to talk about the person that we can't see him, but he's really there.
我给大家看一个照片。
Let's see a picture.
这是我们这是整个的这种电磁波的谱或者光谱。
This is the spectrum of the light.
上面那一排黄色的。但我们看最这是最左边是伽马射线。最右边有 AM, TV, FM, 短波长波收音机的波。
So the top yellow bar is the showing of the spectrum of the light. The most left is gamma rays, and the most right is ultra.
所以我们看可见光就在中间很小的一部分。
But we can see that the light we can see is only very narrow part in the middle.
所以有很多东西我们看不见的存在，圣灵就是一位。
So there's many things we can't see, but it's real.、嗯、but Holy Spirit is one of them.
我们今天就来讨论讨论我们亲爱的圣灵。
We're going to talk about our dear Holy Spirit today.
我们一起来读一下经文。
Let's read the scripture together.
就三节的约翰福音十四章，你用中文也好，英文也好，我们一起来读。一二三。
So we're going to read the book of John. We can read in English and Chinese either.
也一二三。你们若爱我，就必遵守我的命令。我要求父，父就另外赐给你们一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在，就是真理的圣灵，乃世人不能接受的，因为不见他，也不认识他，你们却认识他，因他常与你们同在，也要在你们里面。阿们。我们一起有些祷告。
Let's pray together.
天父上帝，我们再次聚集到你的面前。
Dear Heavenly Father, we're gathered in front of you again.
在这个有些寒冷的冬天的早上。
It's in this chilly winter morning.
但是我们求你用你圣灵的火来温暖我们。
May you warm us with the flame of your Holy Spirit.
当我们无论讲你的话还是听你的话的时候，我们能够感觉到圣灵的火在燃烧。
Let us feel the flame of Holy Spirit when we preach and listen to your word.
求你再次拥抱我们。
May you brave us again.
再次的来光照我们。
Let's lighten us again.
让我们更好的认识你。
Let us to know you better.
奉耶稣基督的圣名祷告。
We pray in Jesus' holy name.
Amen. Amen.我们今天来讨论一下圣灵。
We're going to talk about Holy Spirit today.
根据圣经，还有很多基督徒的经验，我们知道物质世界并不是全部。
According to the Bible and a lot of experience of Christians, we know that the material world is not everything.
还有一个与物质世界并存共存的属灵的世界。
So along with the material world, there's a spiritual world.
圣灵就属于这个属灵的世界。
So the Holy Spirit is belong to this world.
当我们讨论圣灵或者属灵的世界的时候，人们会有不同的回应。
So when we talk of the Holy Spirit and or the spiritual world, the people can have different reactions.
我想在座的也会有不同的回应。
I think the people here today is maybe you have different reactions.
有些人会觉得很怀疑，真的吗？属灵的世界。
Somebody thought about it. Let me ask whether there is really there's a spiritual world.
那是不是只是想象小说啊
？It's maybe it's just imagination. Only in the novel.
但是。没有关系，当你愿意去讨论，愿意和向上帝敞开的时候，我相信上帝会帮助你知道这是真实的。
But it doesn't matter when you would like to open your heart to God and talk to Him, He will open your heart to see it.
我更多的人可能会对此不屑一顾。
I think more people they don't really care about it.
Peter 别讲这个了，要现实一点。
So Peter, don't talk about these things. It doesn't make sense.
我们要现实一点。
We need to be living the real world.
尤其是当人被一些眼前的需要、一些物质的需要压得喘不过气的时候。
So especially when people are overwhelmed by the material needs.
需要解决房子的问题。
So they may need to pay the mortgage,
需要付账单
pay the bills.
有人我们所爱的人生病了
maybe the loved one was sick.
或者有些人只关心 得到名声、地位、权力的时候
，or people only care about the fame, the success, or the gaining the power.
讨论属灵的看不见的事情。
But when talking about the invisible spiritual world,
对他们而说很可笑。
For them, it's quite ridiculous.
是不是呢
？Is it?
对有些基督徒而言
，to some Christians.
我们一提圣灵，可能会觉得很紧张。
They will be nervous when we talk about Holy Spirit.
心里想 ，Peter， 我们又不是灵恩派的教会，我们是浸信会。
So they will ask me, Peter, we're not a Pentecostal church, we're a Baptist church.
我们为什么要讨论圣灵呢
？Why we need to talk about Holy Spirit？
我们是教会。
We're a church.
我们读圣经。
We need to read the Bible.
圣经讨论圣灵
，But the Bible talking about Holy Spirit.
所以我们一定要讨论圣灵。
So we need to talk about Holy Spirit.
而且，教会是由圣灵生的，需要在圣灵里面行走，也需要结出圣灵的果实。
So also the church was born by Holy Spirit and should walk in Holy Spirit and bear fruits of Holy Spirit.
我们当然需要认识圣灵。
We must know Holy Spirit.
还有一些基督徒。他们觉得自己的灵命，一个基督徒的生活很枯燥，很空洞。
And also some Christians they think their life is boring and empty.
他们有一个真实的渴望，希望和上帝建立真实的连结。
So they really have desire to connect with God.
弟兄姐妹们。耶稣知道我们需要认识圣灵。
Dear brother and sister, Jesus know that we need Holy Spirit.
在他讲这段话之前，在他讲这段话的时候，在他钉十字架之前，他的门徒们很难过。
Their disciples was very sad when before he go to the cross.
他对他门徒说：“你们心里不要忧愁，你们信神也当信我。”
He told his disciples that let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me.
在第十六节，他说：“我要求父，父就另外赐给你们一位保惠师，叫他永远与你们同在。”
In the number 16, he said, "And I will pray the Father, and He shall give the another Comforter, that He may abide with you forever."
耶稣还说我去是与你们有益的我若不去保惠师就不到你们这里来我若去就差他来。
Jesus also said that it is expedient for you that I go away. If I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I depart, I will send him unto him.
耶稣说圣灵是与我们有益的。
Jesus said the Holy Spirit benefit to us.
我今天就和大家分享三点圣灵的三个特质。
So today I'm going to share with you the three characteristics of Holy Spirit.
第一个，圣灵是我们的保惠师。
The first one, Holy Spirit is our comforter.
耶稣说圣灵是另一位保惠师。
Jesus said Holy Spirit and another comforter.
那第一位是谁呢？
What is the first one?
Jesus Christ, 耶稣基督他自己。
The first one is Holy Spirit, the first one is Jesus Christ himself.
所以圣灵的工作和耶稣基督的工作很类似一样都是为了我们为了我们的救恩。
So, the Holy Spirit and Jesus Christ are doing the similar things. They are all for our salvation.
保惠师这个词我给大家稍微说一点点这个原文。
Let's talk about the original word of the comforter.
因为我只知道一点点。
Because I know only a little about it.
就在希腊语里面叫做 Parakletos.
In Greek, it's called Parakletos.
咱们一起说一下好吗？来，一二三。
Kletos.
哦，太好了！你们说的比我们俩说的都好听。我给大家介绍一下文化背景。
Let's talk about the cultural background of this world.
人们会在不同的场合中间用这个词。
So, people can use this word in different scenarios.
比如在法庭上。
For example, in the court.
我作为被告。
I was accused.
我需要另外一个人帮我做见证，证明我没有罪。
I need another person to speak for me to prove that I'm not a sinner.
或者我需要请我的律师来代我发言。
Or I need to invite my defense lawyer to speak to me.
那个证人和辩护律师就叫 Parakletos.
So the witness person and the defense lawyer, they can be called as Parakletos.
或者当士兵们打仗的时候。
So when the soldiers in the fighting field,
哎呀，我们输了，很低头丧气。
And when they lost, they are very frustrated.
这时候，一位将军走进来。
So in this time, a general come into them.
他给我们发表一个演讲。
And he speaks make a speech for them.
我们重新鼓舞士气。
And encourage them.
这个将军就是 Parakletos。
The general is called Parakletos。
或者是当我们遇到困难的情况。
When facing difficulties。
我们的房子坏了。
Our house damaged。
我们找王军弟兄寻求一些建议。
We're going to ask Terry to help us。
王军就是 Parakletos。
And at this time, at that moment, Terry is Parakletos。
所以这个总之就是当我们遇到困难和需要的时候 Parakletos 会来帮助我们。
So in general, that Parakletos Kletos is going to help us when we are in difficulties.
所以这个词它可以翻译成保惠师。
So this word has been translated into a comforter.
老师
teacher.
辩护律师
defense lawyer.
顾问
counselor,
帮助者
helper,
导师
and tutor,
等等等等
and so on.
所以耶稣向我们介绍这位保惠师。
Why Jesus introduced this comforter to us?
因为他知道我们具体的需要。
Because he know that we need the comforter.
我们可能会面对撒旦的控告。
Maybe we're facing of the accusation of Satan.
你们撒旦控告过你们吗？
Does Satan accuse you ever?
有没有啊？哦，经常。
It's always.
撒旦会控告你的过去。
Satan can accuse your past.
他会不断的回放你很多痛苦的记忆。
He's going to replay the bad memories in your brain.
你犯的错误。
What mistakes you have been made.
你年轻的时候犯的罪。
And the sin you have committed when you're young.
他想要让你裹足不前。
He wants you to stop there.
用你的过去让你裹足不前。
And stop there and bind you with your past experience.
这样的你就不能够有信心去拥抱上帝给你一个新的未来了。
So in this way, you have no ability to embrace the bright future that God gave to you.
他也会控告你的现在。
And he also accuses what you're doing right now.
他会指出你每一个不足。
And he will point every imperfect point when you're in your life.
他指出你多么的不完美。
And he will tell you that how imperfect you are.
他抓住你的缺点不放。
He grabbed your defect.
他抓住你里面隐藏的罪恶不放。
And he grabbed the hiding sins in your heart.
让你产生一种感受。
He wants to create a feeling for you.
你永远不够好。
You're never getting good enough.
你永远无法取悦上帝。
You can never please God.
他想让你和上帝的恩典爱脱节。
And he wants you to separate with God's grace and God's love.
至少这是我的经历。
At least it's my experience.
这个星期我在西三一大学和一些牧者还有一些基督徒的领袖有一个聚会。
This week, I have a fellowship with the Christian leaders and pastors in the Trinity Western University.
一个弟兄分享了他的经历。
And one of brothers shared his experience.
他的经历也提醒我，我们有的时候也会自己控告自己。
His experience remind me that sometimes we accuse ourselves as well.
他说疫情之后他的生活发生很多的变化。
So he said that after pandemic, there are a lot of changes in his life.
变得越来越糟糕。
Everything's getting worse.
他说他对自己很失望。
He's disappointed with himself.
觉得自己的生活很悲惨。
And he said his life is so miserable.
他很讨厌自己。
He doesn't like himself.
所以有的时候我们不仅撒旦控告我们，我们自己也会控告厌恶自己。
So sometimes not only Satan can accuse us, but also we can accuse ourselves.
值得庆幸的是，因为我和他的见面，
Luckily, the meeting between us,
不是我，是我们大家。
It's we, not just me.
我们一起的交通祷告，他觉得他有的很大的帮助。
And we communicate and pray together. And after that, he feel he is getting better.
我们一起来祷告，感谢上帝。
We pray and thank God.
所以耶稣知道我们在这个世界上有挑战。
So Jesus knows that we're facing challenges in this world.
他知道我们需要另外一位保惠师。
And he knows that we need another comforter.
我们面对我们的罪，我们面对这些控告。
In front of our sins and in front of these accusations,
圣灵要把上帝的爱应运行在我们的生命里。
And Holy Spirit, he wants to carry out the love of God in our heart.
让上帝的爱成为我们个人的经历。
And let the love of God become our personal experience.
让我们真的知道上帝爱我们。
Let us really know that God loves us.
我们看下一个经文，在罗马书的五章第五节。
Let's see the next scripture. It's in the book of Romans, chapter 5, verse 5.
后半节说，因为所赐给我们的圣灵将神的爱浇灌在我们的心里。
So the second part of this verse is that because the love of God is shed abroad in your hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us.
下一节的罗马书的八章十六节。
So the next is book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 16.
说圣灵与我们的心同证，我们是神的儿女。
The Holy the Spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God.
弟兄姐妹们，我们有很多的差异。
Dear brothers and sisters, we have a lot of
difference.
We have lots of differences.
但是有一点我们是共同的。
But there's one thing we're the same.
你和我还有朱弟兄，我们都不完美。
You and me and Brother Nigel, we're all imperfect.
我们不完美，但是上帝的爱是完美的。
We're imperfect, but God's love is perfect.
圣灵把上帝的爱，完美的爱，充满在我们的心里。我们一个不完美的人，我们可以坦然地来到上帝的面前。
Holy Spirit, fill out our heart.With the perfect love of God, so we can boldly come to in front of God.
我们在上帝的爱里面，我们抬起头来拥抱这位父亲。
We can be raised up in front of God's love, and we can embrace our dear Father.
当我们面对这些指责的时候，上帝的爱和接纳给我们力量，抵挡撒旦的控告。
The God's love can give us strength to resist the accusation of Satan in front of the accusation from him.
上帝的爱和接纳帮助我们爱自己，接纳自己。
The love and acceptance of God help us to accept and love ourselves.
耶稣知道我们这样的需要。
Jesus know our need of this kind.
耶稣也知道我们会灰心丧气。
So Jesus also know that there sometimes we're very disappointed, frustrated.
这个世界很美好。
The world is very beautiful.
但是有的时候生活却不容易。
But it's not easy to live in this world.
我们是耶稣基督的战士。
We are the soldier of Christ.
但有的时候我们会失去勇气，丧失斗志。
But sometimes we can lose our courage and our hope.
我们需要属天的资源来帮助我们过属灵的生活。
So we need the spiritual bread to live a godly life.
所以耶稣派圣灵来帮助我们。
So Jesus sent the Holy Spirit to help us.
弟兄姐妹们，当你要跟随耶稣基督的时候，当你跟随耶稣，跟随上帝呼召的时候，
Dear brothers and sisters, when you plan to follow Jesus Christ, follow the call of God,
我想你和我一定会有灰心的时候。
I think at that moment we have the frustrating moment once in a while.
因为上帝其实是不断的来拓展我们，呼召我们做一些有挑战的事。
And because God wants to stretch us and let us do something challenging.
让我们成长更多。
In order for us to grow up.
在这个路途中间我们会有灰心的时候。
But in this course, we have a time, we have the moment of frustrating.
但圣灵会一直来鼓励我们，帮助我们。
But the Holy Spirit will encourage us and strengthen us always.
也给我们智慧来引导我们。
Give us wisdom to follow him.
我想我们在座的人，很多人都经历过上帝的圣灵的安慰、鼓励、引导。
I think everybody here, you have the experience of being comforted by the Holy Spirit and being guided by the Holy Spirit.
这是我们的保惠师。
He is our comforter.
他的第二个特点就是与我们同在。
The second characteristic is Holy Spirit is with us.
同在意味着什么呢？
What does it mean of being with us?
同在，这个词我们经常会说到。
So being with us, we are always talking about being with us.
同在意味着肩并肩一起走。
The being with us, that means he will walk with us side by side.
一同经历所有的一切。
And experience everything together.
圣灵在与你同行。
The Holy Spirit being with us.
在你人生的每一个台阶，每一个小站。
And in every step or every stop in your life.
经历高低起伏。
And no matter whether in high or valley,
从你成为基督徒的那一刻到最后的一口气。
From the moment you became a Christian until your last breath in this world.
但很多时候我们并不认为上帝与我们同在。
But lots of times we don't think that Holy Spirit is being with us.
有的时候我觉得阳光明媚，上帝与我们同在。
Sometimes in a sunny day that you think, oh, God is being with us.
阴天下雨的时候，觉得上帝好像不与我们同在。
But in the raining day, that's you think you can't feel anything about God.
在一些重要的时刻，我们觉得上帝与我们同在。
In some important moment, we feel that God is with us.
在一些非常琐碎平凡的时候，我们常常不觉得上帝与我们同在。
But in our regular days, we can't feel anything about God.
最近我学了一个词。
Recently I learned a word.
对，生活中的自然神论者。
As God. What about this? I can't find it.
Yeah. 生活中的自然神论者，自然神论，自然神论，生活中的自然神论者。
Oh, it's
practical deism, a deist.
Oh yeah, so it's called practical deist.
啊，这就这个自然神论是一个哲学流派，大家可能有些人听说过，它指有些人，一些人他们相信造物主上帝。
Oh, the practical deist is one of school of philosophy. They believe that God is the one that create everything.
但是上帝创造完这个世界之后，就去夏威夷度假了。
He think that after God create the world, he will on vacation.
所以他根本就不关心这个世界。
He doesn't care about the world.
所以我们和神之间也没有联系。
We have nothing to do with God.
他说很多基督徒在生活中就是自然神论者。
Many of the Christians in their lives, they are kind of practical deist.
因为我们的生活和上帝没有关系。
Because our life has nothing to do with God.
但耶稣说圣灵与我们同在。
But Jesus said the Holy Spirit is being with us.
所以我们基督徒面临的挑战。
So the challenges are we Christians in front.
不是说上帝不在这里，我们要去找到上帝。
The real challenge is not that God is not there, but the real challenge is we need to find God.
It's not God is not here. We need to find Him. 我们真正的挑战是上帝就在这里。我们需要意识到他的存在。
The real challenge is that God is really here. We need to be aware of His being.
啊，这个翻译的好，喜欢这个词 aware， 就是我们能够意识到、感知到神的存在。
So I like this word, but that means that we need to be aware that God is here.
所以基督徒的生活其实就是培养这种对上帝同在的感知。
So the Christian life, one of the purpose of Christian life is gradually feel that get the feeling of being with God.
基督的生活就是意识到并且和这位神共同生活。
The Christian life is being aware of the presence of God and living with God.
当我们越来越感受到神的同在的时候，我们的生命就会发生改变。
When we are getting more feeling that the God is being with us, our life is going to be changed.
我们怎样感受神的同在呢
？How can we feel that?
我待会儿和大家分享。
I will share with you later.
所以圣灵与我们同在，但是这并不意味着圣灵会承担我们所有的责任。
The Holy Spirit is being with us. Doesn't mean He will take all the responsibility of us.
并不意味着他会为我们做所有的事情。
It doesn't mean He will do everything for us.
因为圣灵在我们生命中有一个美好的旨意。
Because Holy Spirit have the beautiful goals in our life.
圣灵是帮助我们成长更像耶稣基督。
Holy Spirit will help us to grow up and getting more and more like Jesus.
也发展我们的品格。
And also build up our character.
来实现我们的潜能。
And help us find our potentials.
所以圣灵不会把他的智慧强加给我们。
But Holy Spirit won't force us to accept His wisdom.
圣灵也不会把他的意愿强加给我们。
And also, he won't force us to accept his wills.
圣灵可能会督促我们、引导我们、感动我们，但他不会控制我们。
Holy Spirit will urge us and guide us, but he won't control us.
圣灵不要我们做机器人。
Holy Spirit doesn't want us to be a robot.
圣灵就像一个教练。
Holy Spirit is just like a coach.
他的目标是帮培养我们成为一个好司机。
His purpose is train us to be a good driver.
但是圣灵不会开我们的车，让我们在车里面睡觉。
But he won't drive for us and let us to sleep in the car.
所以我们有神的同在，但是我们还需要成长，需要尽责任。
But even though God and Holy Spirit is being with us, we still need to take our responsibilities, do what we need to do.
因为这是圣灵在我们心里的工作，让我们成为一个成熟成长，有品格，有发挥恩赐，明白神的呼召的基督徒。
So this is the purpose of Holy Spirit. He wants us to be a mature Christian and serve him with our talents.
所以我们还需要尽自己的责任，我们需要祷告，需要思考，需要分析，判断，做决定。
So that means we still need to take our responsibilities. We need to think, analyze, and or making decisions by ourselves.
我们也需要学习认识这位圣灵，怎样更好的与圣灵同行。
We still need to learn how to know more about Holy Spirit and walk with Holy Spirit.
不知道我这一点有没有讲清楚。
I don't know whether I express it clearly.
好的，我有点紧张，我看到有一个人点头，我就赶紧 OK 了。
I'm a little bit nervous, so when it's...
好，我们看第三点。
The third point.
圣灵住在我们里面。
The Holy Spirit is in us.
在第十七节。
And in the verse 16.
就是真理的圣灵乃是世人不能接受的，因为不见他也不认识他，你们却认识他，因他常与你们同在，也要在你们里面。
So verse 17, even the spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it sees him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be within you.
好，我问大家，看这个经文，是这里说世人能不能看到圣灵。
So I would like to ask you what does people can see the Holy Spirit?
我们基督徒能不能看见圣灵？
So we Christians can we see the Holy Spirit?
但是这里说我们却能认识他。
But here in thisscripture that he said we can know him.
没有人能够看见他，但我们却可以认识他。
Nobody can see him, but we can know him.
因为他常与我们同在，也要住在我们里面。
Because he's been with us always and be in us.
如果圣灵只是在我们的外面，因为圣灵无处不在，如果他只是在我们的外面，在一个固定的地方，比方说教会。
If the Holy Spirit only in outside, in somewhere, for example, in the church,
我们必须到教会才能够遇见他。
We have to meet him in the church.
但是这里说圣灵就在我们里面。
But here it said that Holy Spirit is in us.
我们到任何地方都有他的同在。
Wherever we go, the Holy Spirit is being with us.
我们可以学习来感知到他，来认识他。
We can learn how to know him, how to understand him.
他在我们里面意味着他在我们里面做各个层面上来做工。
He's in us means that he's in our heart doing different kind of works.
他们在我们的思想中做工。
He's doing work in our mind.
他来引导我们进入神的真理。
And guide us to the truth of Bible.
来更新我们的思想。
Renew our thoughts.
让我们更加的明白圣经真理的美妙。
We're let us to know better about the wonderfulness of Holy Spirit, of the Bible.
那我们该不该做一件事情呢？
Do we have to do it?
基于我刚才分享的第二点。
So based on the second point I shared,
我们需要做什么呢？
What we need to do?
上 YouTube? YouTube 可以，你要听好的讲道。我们需要殷勤的来思想上帝的话。
So we need to work hard to think about the Word of God.
尽我们的责任来配合这位圣灵。
Take our responsibility to cope with Holy Spirit.
圣灵也在我们的情感中工作。
And the Holy Spirit also works in our emotions.
我们的情感对上帝来说也很重要。
Our emotions are very important to God.
他理解我们所有的情感。
He understands all the emotions.
我们的平安、喜乐。
Our peacefulness, our joy.
我们的悲伤、
our、
我们的失望。
And disappointed.
我们的绝望。
Our sadness.
我们的恐惧。
Our fears.
我们的盼望。
Our hope.
我们的嫉妒。
Our jealousy.
我们的感恩。
Our thanksgiving.
他了解我们所有的情感。
He understands all our feelings.
他在我们的情感里面做工来净化他们。
He works in our emotions to purify them.
当我们向上帝敞开我们的心扉的时候，
Whenever we open our heart to God,
圣灵就像水一样。
His Holy Spirit is like the water.
他会深入到我们内心的最深处去爱我们。
And pour into our heart to the deep part and to love us.
来关心我们。
And care about us.
来医治我们。
And heal us.
来更新我们。
And renew us.
圣灵在我们的情感中间也在做工。
So, Holy Spirit also works in our emotions.
所以我们也需要学习向上帝来敞开心扉。
So we need to learn to open our heart to God.
这样子我们才能够和上帝建立真正的情感上的连接。
So in this way we can have the real relations with God in our emotions.
这才是真正的关系。
This is the real connection.
你想想你和你的家人和朋友。
Think about the relations with your family members and friends.
真正的关系一定是有情感的连接。
The real connection must have the connection with of emotions.
圣灵也在我们的意志中间做工。
Holy Spirit can also work in our wills.
圣灵的邀请我们相信上帝，跟随上帝，顺服上帝。
So Holy Spirit invites us to believe in God and obey God and follow Him.
就像今天这个诗歌唱的，信而顺服。
Just like the song we're going to sing in the morning, that's trust and obey.
若要得主里喜乐。
If you want to get the joy in Christ,
就要顺而顺服。
You have to trust and obey.
圣灵也在我们的欲望中间做工。
And also, the Holy Spirit is doing work in our desires as well.
我们的欲望是一个很复杂的世界。
Our desire is a very complicated world.
那里有最美妙的东西。
There's the most beautiful things there.
也有最丑陋的东西。
And there's most ugly things there as well.
我们合理的欲望是上帝的恩赐。
Our reasonable desire is the grace from God.
它带来让我们感到满足。
He gave us a feeling of satisfaction.
但是邪情私欲。
But the adultery, but the adultery.
还有上瘾。
And addiction.
这些会摧毁我们的生命。
And they will destroy our lives.
我最喜欢的一节经文之一。
The most, one of my most favorite scripture is.
是罗马书的七章第八节，我没有列在这里。
Oh, it's the book of Romans, the chapter seven, verse eight.
是保罗在处理自己这种邪情私欲。
Is this scripture describe the how Apostle Paul dealing with his desires, bad desires?
经文说，罪趁着机会就借着诫命，叫猪般的贪心在我心里发动。
Oh, it's fine.
Seven章八节，嗯。
So, but sin taking occasion by the commandment, wrought in me all manners of concoctions, for without the law, sin was dead.
保罗在处理自己的邪情私欲。
Paul is dealing with his bad desires.
我们到罗马书第八章十一节。
We're going to the book of Romans, chapter 8.
保罗说，然而叫耶稣从死里复活者的灵，若住在你们心里，那叫基督耶稣从死里复活的，也必借着住在你们心里的圣灵，使你们必死的身体又活过来。八章十一节。
But if the spirit of him has raised up Jesus from the dead, the well in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you.
圣灵会重新整理我们内心世界的一切。
So the Holy Spirit will renew our inside world.
让光照在里面。
And let the light shining up in him.
让混乱变为有序。
And get rid of the chaos.
让我们能够更新。
So we can get renewed.
总之，圣灵是耶稣赐给我们的宝惠师，与我们同行，也在我们里面更新。
So in general, Holy Spirit is the comforter that God gave to us, and He will walk with us.
那我们应该做什么呢？
But what we need to do?
我们应该配合这位圣灵。
So we need to cooperate with Holy Spirit.
我们需要花时间与圣灵独处。
So we need to spend time to be with Holy Spirit alone.
与圣灵来相遇，来相交。
And meet with Holy Spirit and communicate with Holy Spirit.
我给大家介绍两个属灵的操练。
So I will practice to practice of how to the get Holy Spirit.
在前一章的提摩太前书四章第八节提到一句话。
So in the first Timothy chapter 4, verse 8.
操练身体益处还少，唯独敬虔凡事都有益处，因有今生和来生的应许。
For bodily exercise, profiteth little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having promise of a life that now is, and of that which is to come.
所以我们知道锻炼身体对我们的锻炼身体对身体好，所以我们属灵的操练对我们灵命很重要。
So we know that our physical exercise is good for our body, but we think that we know that the practice in our spirit is good for our heart.
我给大家介绍两个操练。
I will introduce two practices.
可能大家很多人已经知道，第一个就是数算神的恩典。
So maybe you know it about you know it already. The first one is counting blessings.
我们生活很忙乱的时候，我们常常感受不到神的同在。
Whenever we're in chaos or busy with our lives, we can feel the presence of Holy Spirit.
但是当我们有意识的去数算神的恩典的时候，我们会发现上帝的祝福一直陪着我们。
But whenever we count the God blessings consciously, we can find that the God's grace is always with us.
我看到一个比喻特别美。
I saw a very beautiful metaphor.
他说，上帝的恩典就像夜空中的星星一样。
He said the God's grace is like the stars in the sky.
我们不注意的时候，基本上看不到它。
Whenever we didn't pay attention to it, we almost didn't see it.
你还记得你上次看星星是什么时候吗？
Can you remember the last time you
啊，昨天
you look up for stars?
哦，我们是一个团队。
Still said he looked at the stars yesterday.
你抬头看星星注目的时候
when you look up the stars and pay attention to it,
你会发现越来越多的星星闪现出来了。
So you will see more and more stars gradually.
上帝的恩典在我们的生命中也是这样子。
The God's grace in our life is just like the stars.
当我们去有意识的数算神的恩典的时候，就发现恩典太多了。
Whenever we count the God's blessings consciously, we can find a lot of blessings in our life.
这可以是我们每天的操练。
So this can be our daily practice.
也可以是每周、每个月、每个季节、每一年的操练。
Or we can do it monthly, yearly, and weekly.
我想邀请大家来做这样的一个操练。
I want to, would like to invite everybody to start this practice.
你们做一个月试一试。
You can keep it for 1 month.
每天列出上帝五个恩典。
So list 5 graces daily.
看看有什么不一样。
Let's see what happened.
这是第一个操练。第二个操练。
This is first practice.
就是默想经文。
So the second one is meditating the scriptures.
我们现在的人会认为越快越好。
So right now, the people right now, they think that's the quicker, the better.
但是有些事情上是越慢越好。
But for some things, the slower, the better.
比方说约会的时候。
For example, as when you're dating.
喝咖品咖啡的时候。
And we're in coffee time.
品一个甜点的时候。
And also enjoy the dessert.
默想经文就像品咖啡、品甜点、约会一样。
So meditating the scripture is just like the dating, the enjoying the coffee and dessert.
你挑出几节经文，慢慢的读。
You pick up a couple of the scriptures and read it slowly.
如果有一个句子或一个词让你有一些想法和感受的时候，就停在那里。
So, if there's a one word or few words, make your stimulate you.
然后与神来分享你的感受和想法。
So you can stop there and share your feelings with God.
我看到两个比喻来描述这个。
I saw two metaphors describe they think these kind of things.
就像第一个，就像狗掉了一块骨头到角落里面慢慢啃一样。
The first metaphor is just the dog chewing a bone.
它不是为了填满肚子。
He doesn't want to fill his stomach.
这叫品味。
He just want taste the taste.
第二个就像蜜蜂在花丛中采蜜一样。
The second one is just like the bees collecting honey in the flowers.
一个蜜蜂落在一个花上。
A bee landing on the flower.
他就把里面的蜜都采出来。
He pick up all the honeys inside it.
我们默想上帝的话也是这样子。
When we meditating the God's words, it's just like this.
你如果圣灵借着一两个字感动你，你就在那里把这个蜜吸收出来。
If the Holy Spirit help the word of the God's word touch you.You just like the bees, picking up the honeys on flowers.
这两个操练可能会帮助大家更加意识到神的同在。
So these two practices may help you to be aware the God's presence.
更加知道圣灵怎样在你心里工作。
And you will know more that the Holy Spirit is working in your heart.
当然了。你需要和别人来分享。
But of course, you need to share your experience with others.
有属灵的分辨。
You need to discern the spiritually.
在教会历史上，第四世纪有一个教父，他叫 John Chrysostom.
So in the Christian history, there's a There's a church father is called John Chrysostom.
他有一句话。
He has one saying.
他说，找到你的心门。
So find the door of your heart.
你就会找到天国之门。
So you will discover that it is door of the kingdom of God.
因为神的国就是公义、平安和圣灵里的喜乐。
For the kingdom of God is righteousness and peace, joy in Holy Spirit.
我们在这个世上，借着圣灵就可以体会到天国的荣美。
So, when we live in this world, we can experience the sweetness of the heaven with the Holy Spirit.
我们期待天国最终的降临。
We're expecting the arriving.Arrival of the heaven.
耶稣在登山宝训马太福音的五章第八节说
So Jesus said in the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 8,
清心的人有福了，因为他们必得见神。
The pure person is blessed because he must see the God.
当我们的心被更加洁净的时候
When our heart is being purified,
我们就会更多的意识到神的同在
We'll be more aware of the presence of God
瞻仰神的荣美
And see his beautiful face
阿们
Amen
谢谢大家
Thank you
我们一起来祷告
We can have a prayer
天父我们真的谢谢你你是一位奇妙的神
Heavenly Father, we thank you. You are a wonderful God.
我们虽然不能够看见你
Even though we can't see you,
你说我们却可以认识你
But you said we can know you.
主啊，我们都是小学生
God, we are all immature person.
我们在属灵的事上都是小学生
We are all immature spiritually.
请你来帮助我们
May you help us.
让我们体会到你圣经里面隐藏的珍宝
And may we see your treasure in the Holy Spirit.
体会到与你交流的甘甜
And may we experience the sweetness of communicating with you.
让我们知道你长阔高深的爱
May we know your love is so wide and deep.
让我们知道你的荣美
May we know your beautiful face.
让我们知道你的智慧
Know your wisdom.
好让我们也全心全意地爱你
In order for us to love you completely
我们也能够和弟兄姐妹们在你里面有这样的甘甜的交通
And we can also share this feeling with our sisters and brothers
请你垂听我们
May you listen to our prayer
引领我们每一个人
Guide us
在你里面长进
And grow up in you
奉耶稣基督的圣名
We pray in Jesus' name
Amen, Amen.